What's poppin', man? You already know what it is, man. Your boy Young Zo, Hot Boy Entertainment CEO, Tighter Clothing CEO. We back at it with the Rap Shack, man.
It's been a minute since you seen the guy. I've been on the side and trying not to condense the vibe. Stay away from guys who hide, but still convince the lies. Niggas really die for trying to go against the tribe. Yeah, and keep a nigga out your politics. Don't address the hood, go at the nigga it's a problem with. Since I took some time, I've been noticing a lot of shit. My squad is dominant, been accumulating accomplishments. LLCs, and I expand a couple brands.
We started this, I'll say probably like maybe a year or two ago, probably like 2 years ago. It was something that me and my dad had originally talked about, you feel what I'm saying? And it was something to pay homage to my younger brother and my older brother who passed away, you feel me, back in 2012. Pretty much Titus stems from my little brother's name, Tyquees, T-Y, and then my older brother, Dewan, with the D, you feel me? And then the A was going to be for something completely different. But after my father passed, then it was only right, you feel me, to make that A for Alonzo Sr., you feel what I'm saying? So that's how Tighter came about.
What I mean, y'all? You know what I'm saying? You already know what time it is, you feel me? It's your boy Young Zo, Hot Boy Entertainment CEO, you dig? I got everything y'all need, man, you know what I'm saying? Come support your local black entrepreneurs, you feel what I'm saying? First of all, let me show this to y'all real quick. This is handmade, you feel me? Living Love, wax candles, whatever you need, you feel what I'm saying? Living Love on Instagram, y'all check that out. We got shit for the ladies, you feel what I'm saying? Classy shit, you know what I mean? We got shit here that's gonna keep you warm. The leather joints, you feel what I'm saying? Of course, my custom pieces, you know what I mean? Tighter clothing, you know, the half shirts, you feel me? Long sleeve, come get your drip, you know what I mean? It don't stop there though, you feel me? I got throwbacks, you know what I mean? We got throwbacks in this motherfucker, you know, for days. T-shirts, you feel what I'm saying? All day. Follow me over here real quick. Shout out my homie X, Grease Clothing, you feel me? The dopeness. Brand new t-shirt, size is small, all the way to 3 to 4X, you feel me? Come tap in. I never really thought it was gonna be like on no open up a store type shit. I just wanted to do something to pay homage to the bros and make a couple t-shirts and shit like that, but like I said, once Pops passed and then my love for fashion and clothes and shit like that, and the opportunity presented itself. Actually, funny fucking story, the nigga Show Off is the one that told me about this spot.
Like he said, we go back, like four flats on the Cadillac, the Ville, you feel me? Like, bruh tapped in with me at like 7 in the morning. It was about 7 a.m., nigga, you know what I'm saying? And he was like, bruh, you know, You bringing that pressure, you know, I got my pressure going on, and it's time to make diamonds, so nigga, we doing that, you feel me?
You feel me? I met this nigga at a, I didn't even meet him, I saw him on a fluke at a fucking soul food restaurant on Bradshaw, and, you know, everybody was masked up and shit. I know this nigga body shape, how this nigga stand and shit, so I'm like, Show, he'll pull his mask down, we got to chopping it up and shit, you feel me? And he was like, nigga, if you really trying to do the store shit, you feel me? It's a spot off of Majorfield, nigga, go check it out. And I pulled up, nigga, called dude came through, pretty much nigga got, you know, approved on the spot type shit, you feel me? He told me what the ticket was and signed some paper and shit like that, and nigga, the rest is history, you know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
The little homie, one of my homegirl's nephews, forgot your name, brother, and I apologize. But he came in here, I told him just freehand do what he gotta do, gave him 3 pictures, he went crazy with it. It's my brother Tyquees, it's my brother Dewan, it's my pops, Alonzo Sr., Big Zo, you feel me, Bobo, you feel what I'm saying? And I told homie come in here and just freehand do his thing, bro, and this is the outcome. And of course, we got the family tree on this side, so this is all my siblings' names. All on the wall, you feel me? We deep too out here, bro. We deep out here, you feel me? So, yeah, man. I let him do his thing, bro. It's a beautiful thing, though, you feel me? Absolutely. With Pops, man, Pops have been sick for a while. Mm-hmm. My dad been sick for a long time, you feel me? But me, in my mind, I'm trying to convince myself that this nigga just, he ain't gonna go nowhere. Like, Pops, he's a nigga. He can't pass, you mm-hmm. feel me? So, every time he was in and out the hospital, it was, I never took light of it, but I just always felt like he kept getting right back out. So I'm like, he must have ate the wrong food or drank a soda or something, you feel me? And, you know, he gonna be all right, the nigga gonna be all right. But the last time he went in, nigga was in there for like a month and some change. And I'm like, okay, this one a little different, bro. Mm-hmm. Like, Pops ain't getting out, my nigga. So fuck is going on, you feel me? So they was trying to keep us updated on his health and saying he was getting better. We actually, I FaceTimed him in the hospital, you feel me? And he was with the doctor. He was with the doctor, a nurse, and my cousin and somebody else. So we all got this like conference call, FaceTime thing going on. And he in good spirits, you know what I'm saying? He laughing and joking and saying, I'm going to be good. Don't worry about it. I'm going to get up out of here, you feel me? I'm going to give you some information. I need you to call out to Frisco and tap in with them hospitals. I need this transplant and woo-woo-woo. So I'm making calls and doing X, Y, Z, you feel me? And then my cousin that came out here from Texas, one of my, she more like a sister to me, you feel me? So when she came out here unexpectedly, it was, yeah, I was happy to see her and shit, but I just felt something was wrong, you feel me? So when she came out here, she stayed at my house for a little bit, and she was just acting sad as fuck, you feel me? And I'm just like, she kept crying and shit, and I'm like, bro, you want to tell me something, my nigga? Like, what the fuck is going on? Like, you're hella aggressive, and like, you're not being yourself, like, what's going on type shit. And it was times me and her was by herself, and it's like she wanted to say something, but she wouldn't say it. So fast forward, Pop's still in the hospital. I think my aunt called, which is my cousin. I was just talking about her mom. She called and was like, you know, they about to send your dad home. So I'm like, all right, bet. You feel me? Everything must be peasy, nigga. We A1. And she was like, when he get there, he want to see y'all. You feel me? Like, he want to talk to all of y'all. So I'm like, all right, bet. And she had said something to make me ask her why. I forgot what she said, but I was like, why are you making it seem like this is a goodbye, my nigga? Like, you feel like you know something. Then she start crying. Then I start crying. Then I was like, okay, I kind of see where this shit is going. You feel me? So Pops get to the crib. I pull up on him. We talked. You feel me? Like I said, he in good spirits. You feel me? You know, my dad let a box, so he throwing jabs and shit at me. You know, we fucking around, so I'm thinking everything cool. And make a short story even shorter, shit, my older sister went over there to go visit him, and she called me, nigga, right before I was gonna hop in the shower. She's like, bro, you need to come over here and come see your dad. And I was like, what's going on? Well, she was like, he gone, bro. And I'm like, get the fuck out of here. I dropped my phone, my nigga, and the waterworks, nigga, just wouldn't stop, you feel me? Because if motherfuckers know, if you know, nigga, you know. Nigga, Pops was my dog, you feel me? Like, that was my go-to nigga for everything, bro. Whether it was financial, spiritual, just needed some game, you feel me? He'll come pick me up. We bent corners and shit all through SAC, you know what I'm saying? So when I got the news and I pulled up, all the family outside and shit, and I'm asking motherfuckers, like, yo, is this real? Is this true? Like, is my dad gone in there? And everybody confirmed it. And I wouldn't go in there. They kept asking me to go in there, go say, yo, final. I'm like, I don't want to see my nigga like that. I don't want to remember him like that. You feel me? So I ain't fucking around, bro. So after that, you know, of course, the grieving process started and the funeral and all of that. And I took that pain, my nigga, and that hurt, and just took it up a notch. I'm like, nigga, it was situations I would be in, whatever it was, you feel me, mentally, whatever, and I just think, like, nigga, what would my dad do? Because I ain't never seen my dad down. This nigga always, if he gonna figure something out to make some money, get some money, and nigga don't complain, you feel me? So I'm like, nigga, I gotta get in, you know, Big Zo mode, you feel me? And that's kind of how Tyler came about, you feel me, to pay homage to Pops, you know what I'm saying, type shit, so, yeah. Yes. Left out of part. A conversation I had with my dad, my nigga, but this is how Tyler came about, even the word, you feel me? I made the word up, but the idea came from Pops, because he like, nigga, you been doing this music shit for a long time. This is when he was in the hospital. We talked on the phone. He's like, you been doing this music shit for a long time. He was like, maybe it's time to step outside your comfort zone. He's like, you know, the hood shit is cool, and you want to be a real nigga and all of that, you know what I mean? He's like, I feel like you already solidified, you feel me? He's like, I don't see, that's exactly what he told me. He said, I don't see elderly women rocking a hot boy sweater.
Being your own boss is something niggas don't think about. You ever woke up and seen 40,000 in your bank account on pure hustle, motivation and some blessings? Cut some homies off, them niggas was really lessons. I'm finessing, flexing progression all in my section. I've been sprinting to the money, you niggas relaxing, resting. Opening up a store was one of my last investments. Stagnant in your spot, cause niggas gon' lack progression. We talking about some business, my nigga, I'm all about him. I really miss my dad and nigga been lost without him.
In a hot boy sweater. You feel what I'm saying? At the time, I'm like, Pop, come on, man. I'm finna be global, bro. But he giving me some real gems. He like, nigga, nah. You need a household name, bro. Something that any and everybody can wear. Racist, any kind of racist, anything, you feel what I'm saying? So I'm sitting there brainstorming for like a day or two, nigga, trying to think of a fucking name and shit, and then that's how Tyler came about. Boom. So when he passed, I ain't gonna lie, it kind of put me at a standstill with the music, you feel me? Cause I was cluttered, you feel me? I'm just like, nigga, I'm not focused on shit. Like I need my pops back, you feel me? And then I kept hearing that fucking song. I kept hearing Drake shit. Mm-hmm. And that beat, every time I heard the beat, nigga, I would get chills. I'm like, bro, I love this fucking beat. I'ma just rap to it. I don't know what I'ma do with it. I don't know if I'ma put it on the mix. I don't know. I just wanna rap to it.
And now it ain't no beef. You niggas know my affiliation. The shit that's going on is a whole nother generation. I hollered at the OGs. I'm speaking the truth. I'm in the booth, but I really wanna speak to the youth. If you gon' bang, then nigga bang. But nigga, do that shit with substance. Have some order with it. Put structure in your circumference. I know you niggas tired of losing youngins on the daily. We gotta stick around to be the savior to the babies. Let's make going hard for each other the new treatment. I know you niggas peeping, I'm just saying what you thinking. Let's make going hard for each other the new treatment. I know you niggas peeping, I'm just saying what you thinking, nigga.
Got the women's section, bucket hats, colorful bucket hats, leather pants, long sleeve turtlenecks. I mean, you name it, bro. We got shit popping in here, man. But we ain't done no. Fuck with me. All brand new inventory shit. The bomber jackets, you feel me? You ain't gonna see these nowhere out here, my nigga. Got the bomber jackets, Yeezys, Jordans, I mean, you name it, we got it. You feel what I'm saying? T-shirts, the drip, you feel me? Black Pike, I mean, you name it, bro, we got it. What you need, you feel me? Come holler at me. And on top of that, in this backspace right here, I do hella custom work. I make my own shit, you feel me? With these hands, you feel what I'm saying? Entrepreneurship at its finest, you feel what I'm saying? Me personally, bro, I don't really pay attention to it no more.
Yeah.
I know that sounds like some cliche shit to say, but I promise you, I don't focus on it no more. You feel me? I don't put no energy into it. When the homies call me about, like, I'm that nigga now, when something happens and you come tell me about it, I be like, damn, I didn't even know that. Cause I'm not in the loop.
Right.
I'm doing this shit, bro. I don't give a fuck about that shit, my nigga. Like, it don't concern me. You feel what I'm saying? And when I try to preach my point to make niggas not get into the politics and all that shit, it kind of backfired.
Yeah.
So I just stopped speaking on it. You feel what I'm saying? I'm just like, you know what? Them niggas gonna learn one way or another. Yeah. You feel what I'm saying? Or it's gonna hit them like it hit me to just stay out the shit. You feel what I'm saying? Because it was times, nigga, I got hella calls one day, right? This was like, I want to say last year or sometime. My phone blowing up. You feel me? They blowing my shit up. Hella homies and shit. They DMing me. I'm like, what the fuck is going on? So somebody sent me a screenshot of somebody, I ain't gonna say his name, but this nigga, he has a page, like a YouTube page, channel that he talks about Sacramento gangs and shit like that. But the screenshot I saw, it was like Young Zoe, Fruit Ridge OG, some other shit. And I listened to it. Facts was all the fuck wrong. Everything was wrong. You feel me? The school I went to, who I hang with, like all the shit was wrong. So I called the nigga. I'm like, yo, next time you do some shit like this, homie, let me know, bro. At least I can give you the right facts. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And then the shit you're saying intertwining me with a nigga that's heavily involved in these politics, I feel like you putting a target on me now.
Right.
You feel what I'm saying? Like, don't do that shit, bro. So it be shit like that I gotta address. I don't want to. My whole thing is, bro, and I hope these motherfuckers listen to this shit, my nigga. If you see clear as day how a nigga's moving on a daily basis, and I'm drama free and negativity free, all the shit, don't go out your way to try to pull me in some shit, bro. That's just stupid as fuck to me. You know what I'm saying? It don't really make no sense. Like, you obviously see that this nigga ain't made no diss songs. These niggas over here, these niggas over there, he ain't intertwining with neither one of these groups. He moving in his own lane. But I'm gonna pull him in this shit anyway, some kind of way. I'm gonna put his, like, nigga, get the fuck out of here, bro. Like, that shit is corny to me. And niggas been trying to do that shit for years. And I don't know. I don't do the internet shit. You feel me? I don't do the internet shit.
Yeah, and keep a nigga out your politics. Don't address the hood. Go at the nigga it's a problem with. Since I took some time, I've been noticing a lot of shit. My squad is dominant, been accumulating accomplishments. LLC.
Like I said before, you know, fucking with Show Off, connecting with his camp, and the artist he got. I got an artist by the name of Summer. Be looking out for her real soon. R&B singer. Talented as fuck, play the piano, you know what I mean? I think she played another instrument as well. Beautiful voice. She's gonna be introduced sometime this year. my nigga Lawson, Reddy Lawson, another R&B singer, dope ass dancer, choreography type shit, you feel me? My nigga Mac, you feel me, from Frisco, one of the dopest underrated lyricists in Sacramento to me, to just period. Ain't even gotta be in Sac, nigga, just the nigga hard, you feel me? I was in the lab with this nigga the other day. We threw a beat on, everybody's walking around the studio with their phones out, trying to write shit. This nigga sitting on the couch, just nodding and shit. I like 10 minutes go by, I'm like, bro, what the fuck, nigga, you ain't gonna write?
Right.
He's like, oh, I'm done. This nigga on some Lil Wayne shit. This nigga went to booth and knocked and was hard though. It was, right. You feel me? So shout out my nigga Mac, man. Who else, bro? We fucking with Omega, bro, the brother. The homegirl K Hooks, you feel me? Show Off, of course. We all coming together and pretty much combining our labels together, you feel what I'm saying? And he got the entertainment company, I got the entertainment company, and we just decided to and I've been knowing Show for hella years, you feel me? So it's just only right, you know what I mean? So we got Show got the movie coming out. Nigga, I'm working on my project. I do not have a name for it yet. But I'm just in go mode, you feel me? I'm in go mode right now, nigga. So the music, the new music is gonna be mandatory. That shit's coming for sure this year. Yeah. And the artist gonna be presented to y'all. We got events coming up. I think Show Off trying to put something together, like bringing Atlanta to Sacramento with strippers and shit like that. You know how Show do, bro. He's bringing strippers and shit like that. That don't have a set date yet, but we working on that. I do events at my shop every month, you feel me? So I think next month we're gonna do another sipping shop with the homie B Smooth. He got his own vodka. Shout out to True Legacy Vodka, you feel me? What's going on with you, man? It's your boy Young Zoe. Thank y'all for tuning in, tapping in with the Rap Shack. High Boy Entertainment CEO, Title Clothing CEO, man. Y'all be blessed. Health is wealth, drink water, mind your business, stay out of negativity, you feel what I'm saying? And level up, you feel what I'm saying? 100.
I'm Bruce, man.
Yeah, Mailman, Cash Money, Larry D.
Yeah, man, it's your rule boy, D-Lo, man.
Yo, he Sosa.
That's Connie calling Ginobili, you feel me?
Hey, man, you already know it's Mac J.
OG, what you say?
Man, it's Mr. Fab.
Filthy motherfucking rich.
Yeah.
This Cash Lord Mets, man. Black Squad Mafia.
M-O-Z-Z-Y, man.
Lil Darion.
And it's Shock Style, you live and direct.
Man, you fucking with Rap Shack.
Bristol here fucking with the Rap Shack, P.
I'm in the Rap Shack.
So I'm in here with Rap Shack, man.
Motherfucking Rap Shack, nigga.
Rocking with my Rap Shack. You hear that?
Fuck with Rap Shack, that was that.
Rap Shack.
With Rap Shack, man.
Fuck with Rap Shack.
Back fucking with the Rap Shack.
Rap Shack!
Rap Shack, let's gonna get to it, man.